وهذا الكتاب الصغير الحجم العظيم الفائدة للإمام الشهير بمحيي الدين يحيى بن شرف الحوراني الدمشقي. هذا الإمام ولد عام 631 ومات عام 676، يكون كم عاش من العمر؟ مات سنة 676 وولد عام 631، كم يكون بلغ من العمر؟ 45 سنة. هذا الإمام محله ثناء كبير من أهل العلم، واتفق أهل العلم على تبجيله وتعظيم شأنه ورفع قدره، وله عنايات كثيرة بالعلوم الشرعية كما سنشير إلى ذلك إن شاء الله.
So then the Shaykh, Shaykh Aasim, he mentioned this book, which is small in size, but enormous in the amount of benefit that a person extracts from it, is for the famous Imam, who's famously known as Muhyiddin. His name is Yahya ibn Sharaf al-Dimashqi, al-Hurani al-Dimashqi, and he was born in the year 631 after Hijrah, and he died in the year 676. Look at how long he lived. He lived up to the age of 45 only. Yet at the same time, all of the scholars are in agreement that he's an imam who's virtuous, whose books are, they all have agreement that his status is held high, that he has, and also he put a lot of effort in all of the various Islamic sciences, which the Shaykh Hafidhullah is going to, Shaykh Aasim is going to point to in the next point, i.e. the different uloom of the Sharia, whether it's fiqh or whether it's hadith or whether it's, he's got a lot of efforts in it now.
هذا الإمام ذكر عنه من الفضائل الشيء الكثير في الزهد والورع، والورع وهو شيء ليس من السهل أن يكون الإنسان ملتزما به، وذكر من عبادته وفضائله وصنفت فيه المؤلفات لمكانته رحمه الله، ومع ذلك كان متواضعا حتى أنه لتواضعه كان لا يرضى أن يلقبه أحد بمحيي الدين، بل قال لست في حل من الذي يقول عني محيي الدين. وهذا لا شك من التواضع الذي عليه علماؤنا وعلماء الإسلام رحمهم الله جميعا، وما أجدرنا نحن معشر طلاب العلم على التواضع، وأن يقف الإنسان عند حده، وهذا أمر مهم جدا، والذي يتدبر سيرة أسلافنا وعلمائنا من محدثين ومفسرين وفقهاء يرى الشيء الكثير العجيب في تواضع العلماء، لأنهم يريدون الأمر لله لا لشهرة ولا لسمعة.
With regards to this Imam Nawawi, there's been a lot which has been mentioned about his virtues, about his zuhud, his abstaining from the dunya, and his wara, which is also similar to zuhud but another level. And this having wara is not something which is easy. It's not something to stick to it and to always be a person of wara, have tawadu, have this humility, is not something which is easy. With regards to his worship, his ibadah and his virtues, then books have been authored concerning it and his position and his status. And even with all this, he still remained a person who was humble, a person that had a tawadu. To the point and to the extent that he wasn't happy that people would give him the kunya Muhyiddin. Muhyiddin, it means a reviver of the religion, someone that gives life back to the religion. Someone that gives life, a reviver of the religion. This is obviously, it's a big laqab. And he himself, out of his tawadu and his humility, he wasn't happy to have this title, to the point that he said, إِلَّا أَنَّهُ قَالَ شَيْخ لَسْتُ مِنْ أَخِكَ
لا أحل يعني لا أسمح لا أجيز أحد يتكلم ويلقبني يقول محي الدين.
To the point that he said, I do not allow, I do not permit, I don't give permission, I don't allow for anyone to give me the nickname محي الدين. And the reality was, and this is from my speech, he was a person that he had, if you look at it. She said, from this you find that for the student of knowledge, he has to be a person that has this type of tawad, this type of humility. And he has to also know his boundaries and know his limits, the limits of his knowledge, and stop there. And this is a very, very important issue. This is a very, very important issue that Shaykh Aasim, he mentioned, that a student knows. If you look at the biography of their Salaf, you'll see something which is ajib, which is amazing concerning the level of their humility that they had. Why? Because when they did an action, they did it for Allah. They weren't seeking any type of fame. And they weren't seeking, for example, to make a name. They were doing it for Allah. And this is an indication of their tawadu, that this is why they're tawadu. They weren't seeking fame, or they weren't seeking to make a name. And this is essential and important for a student of knowledge to pay attention to this. Now.